Welcome along to the 2017, wait a second, it's 2018. Welcome along to the 2018 Holiday Parade as we're going to bring you all the action here. A little something different this year. We'll just introduce you to our Master of Ceremonies. You'll hear him throughout the tape. And anybody who's here today will have something different. We're going to be judging this year.
That's right. This is a year of this incarnation of the parade. It's a competition. We have three judges, Alex McCumber, Vanessa Alfred, Daniel Rowe. They're going to be judging each float individually on presentation and their theme out of five. And then the highest score, obviously, is going to be the winner.
And the other thing is, of course, something else happening this year is the Kahnawake Peacekeepers are actually organizing. And, of course, Kyle, one of the beloved peacekeepers here, along with your partner.
I wouldn't call us beloved. More like, okay, we're all right. So they're just going to be coming around the corner in a second. But this is a new thing. Also, we're doing it at night because Christmas is all about the lights, right? You want to see everybody's lights on the houses. All the floats this year are going to be very well illuminated. And we're going to see it. We can see them coming around the corner right now, the first group coming around.
All right. And just before we do that, Clint, there's going to be some fireworks afterwards as well. What can you tell us about that?
Well, we have JoJo Lash there is going to be having the fireworks tonight, donating it. It's really going to be something else. I guess everybody can head up towards the peacekeepers. You can stand up in the big field in the front. They'll be shooting them off around 7 o'clock or so when we finish. But everybody's looking forward to it, and it's going to be something else.
All right. Thank you very much, Clint. And thank you all for joining us here on the program today. And we'll let our Masters of Ceremonies take it away.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here comes our first attraction of the 2018 Winter Holiday Parade. The first car that's lit up like a Christmas tree is our Grand Marshal. And this year, our Grand Marshal is Helen Montour and Trudy Thomas. We got
two of them this year, yeah.
Grand Marshals, plural.
In plural.
Pluralized. So these two ladies were chosen because of their efforts with the Purple Ribbon Walk that took place just this summer. So good on them, and we're going to recognize them for all of their contributions to the community and everyone at large. Look at that car they're in. What a lovely car. Good wave, Kyle. I'm wave. Hi. But the fire is our Grand Marshals, ladies and gentlemen. And since we've known Helen Montour and Trudy Thomas. Give them a big hand. And that sound, of course, every parade in Kahnawake starts with sirens for some reason. And these sirens belong to the Kahnawake Fire Brigade. KFB, KFB. Every year the Fire Brigade enters 3 to 4 vehicles every year.
It looks like they got a little more this time.
That's right. And this year, they've donated the plaques that will be awarded for the best floats in our parade.
Second and third.
Yeah. Yeah. And they're handing out things. There you see, they're all in their gear. Just in case something happens, they're ready to spring into action. Of course, our first responders, they all work so hard and sacrifice so greatly. They work nights, they work weekends,
and look at that,
they work holidays, and they know how to party. Look at that truck.
KFB, they know how to throw Christmas there. They know how to celebrate Christmas.
That's right. You can't spell Christmas without KFB.
For the last few years, K103 has been actually on the ladder vehicle because of the radiothon. But for a change this year, the K1037 team has put together their own float, and we should be seeing them very shortly. Of course, we have a few more vehicles from the fire brigade coming up, and then lots more, about 17 or 18 floats this year. Should be a great parade. Hope you're enjoying it.
That one siren sounds like a video game I had when I was 10.
Sounds like Buzz Lightyear.
Oh, I got the high score. And there's an ambulance. One of our ambulances is being escorted by the lovely Davy Dival. And a second ambulance to follow the first. Because you can never be too safe. All right, we get it. You're an ambulance. Siren, good. Nope, they want more. More sirens, I say. And approaching now, we have the number one entry.
Here we go.
This is the KFCS float. And it is a gingerbread house.
Wow, let's have a big hand.
A lot of people worked really hard on this one. Look at them.
Oh, look at all those lights on there.
Yeah, indeed. The parade initially started by KFCS in 2012. This is the first year they did not organize it, but are still a very important part of the parade. So thanks to them, we're going to be having hot chocolate and coffee after the parade at the Peacekeeper Station.
Woo! And they got their chef's hats for a reason.
Yep. Yeah, they cooked us up a heck of a parade. Very brightly colored, very well lit.
Nice and festive.
That's a great amount of detail that went into that gingerbread house.
There you go.
You can see on the top there's some M&Ms.
Here.
And then along the side.
A great parade. What do you think so far?
We're having a great time. This is KSS's float. A beautiful gingerbread.
So well,
wonderful teamwork.
A lot
it was
of hours
great.
Went into that building.
Did she say
and the
KSS?
Children on the float, each of them wielding
yeah,
a deadly weapon.
I thought so. Sagotiet again has community services. Here's the gang
nice
right here. Here's Derek. Derek, you look like you've cooked up a pretty good.
And following
we
up
our
KSS
best.
Yes,
well,
we have our number
all.
Two float, the Desjardins Chevrolet float. Little snow globe. This is a snow globe with a snowman behind it. Now, Desjardins Chevrolet are always participants in the parade. And they actively donate to the community. And they continuously donate to the PK
yeah.
golf tournaments. And then in brackets it says, say something nice.
Hello.
So, Desjardins, Chevrolet, very nice.
What Kunurado Dano Ne Osurase. There you go. Desjardins.
And here we have animal protection. That's right, our number three entry, the animal protection. They were unable to participate last year as it was too cold, and Deidre White does not like to be cold.
Well, their dogs are well-dressed this year. Look at them all.
They wore their best fur coats. Speaking of Deidre White, she works at Animal Protection and is a part of a local dog walking group, and they are also here to beef up their numbers. Careful,
don't looks like, looks like this parade like has gone to the dog somewhat here. Look at this. We have a great group of dog walkers. Liz here has a couple of them. Holy smokes. What are the names, Liz?
Callie and Mavi. Mavi, the white one is Callie.
Yeah. Yeah. Very, very, very cool. And I like that you're all lit up as well.
Yeah. Okay. If I could hang on to
We'll let you get back what you
gotta do. Okay, Anna.
Hey, look. We have our own G Dibo, the one and only. Oh, yeah. Gene, how are you doing, man?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Not too bad.
It's a little cold, but it's fun. It's lovely. This is Nella. She's a Border Collie Shepherd mix. She came from Greece. She was a rescue dog. And I've had her since almost a year now, last November 22nd, I think we got her.
The Good Witch.
Giving you a workout.
Yes,
and I can see an Emerald
behind.
City
All
guard.
Right, see you later. Merry Christmas.
Who says that nobody can see the Great Oz. Not nobody, not know how. We can see the Wicked Witch standing out there right in front of the parade, the float, rather.
Wow.
And this is the one day of the year that she does nice things. And look at that truck driver, handsome as ever. You see the Tin Man is there, and the Scarecrow, and the Cowardly Lion, all ready to celebrate Christmas. If you look at the back, you see Dorothy's house.
Yeah,
it's in the tornado.
It's right there. It's all it's all rusted up and killing the Wicked Witch of the, was it the East or the South? The other witch, anyway. The other Wicked Witch. And now, coming up, number five. The number five float is from Eno Enterprise Electric. They're a newcomer to our parade. Their theme is Holiday Lights. Holiday Lights. I guess it makes sense that it would be Holiday Lights. They are an electrical company. Look at this one. This entrance by. This is the Kahnawake Youth Center. Number six.
And here's the Youth Center.
You got dancing presence there. Dancing presence. And of course, every child.
And there he is, the executive director himself.
In life and in parades.
There we go, the Kahnawake Youth Center.
The community organization who participates every year. Their representative this year is Jordan Yawak Norton. The theme of the float is Candyland.
Hey, Duda Danu Okwardi.
Oh, and there we have Duda Danu Okwardi, bringing cheer to
they're,
all.
They're no, they're no strangers. There's no strangers to television.
That really, look how
they have their own show, of course, on television here in Kahnawake, so you can catch them anytime. And they've been around for a long time and always a big hit here at these parades here.
Number eight.
This 2018 holiday parade here from beautiful downtown Kahnawake. We're outside the Knights of Columbus Hall. Another float coming up.
2018 Bingo and look at this. King and Queen.
It's the K103 gang with the Bingo King and Queen.
And we want to congratulate them on winning their royal titles. They are joining some K103 staff on the float. You can see their lovely K103 hockey jerseys.
Oh, hey, let's get them over here for a second.
Dancing very awkwardly.
We need a shot of the King and Queen.
Move those hips a little more.
Ho, ho, ho.
You move like the kid in the really thick snowsuit on Christmas Story. Wave those arms.
All righty.
The Bingo King and Queen, ladies and gentlemen. Frank Marquis, Margie Tuax. Let's have a big hand for them. Long may they reign. God save the Queen. Oh, look, Denon Phillips.
Morning, man. Brandon Bordeaux by the water. Look at this. This is a great parade.
I love it. I love it. It's fantastic.
What kind of reaction are you getting?
Save Bingo.
Well, I don't really try to make it about me personally. It's about our organization and our King and Queen this year. They're great. They've loyal Bingo players. And obviously, you know, Joe, it's a big help. You're rocking out the K103M7. I'm loving it. You know, it's really a great parade. It really is. And it's a little bit chilly. You got to keep your legs moving. But we feel like... it's great to have it at this time. It really is. It's a bit of a change. It's at night. You know, I'm really digging it. All the lights are illuminating. It's fantastic.
Well,
the
last few years you've been on with the fire brigade with the, I guess, in kind of a commemoration of the radiothon to you know, get that fire truck, the pumper. But now... K103 has done it on its own, so this is pretty impressive.
Yeah, it's absolutely fantastic. I think it was a great initiative. We had so much dialogue between amongst us at the office and also socially, and I really feel like as if this is what you see in front of you. It's hard work, dedication, and not just us, but all 18 floats that are here. It's really fantastic, and I'm proud to be a part of it.
All right, I know you got to run and catch up to your gang, and congratulations on a great job. Yeah, it's turning out pretty well here today. And you know what? It is winter, it is cold, but if you dress for this, and a lot of people are here, and you can see them all up and down the highway.
We've just been informed that the Catter Memorial Foundation has withdrawn their float from the parade, bah humbug. So instead, in the number nine position, we have the Case Populaire.
The Case Populaire has also been a participant in every parade that we've had so far, every holiday parade.
Oh, actually, I told a terrible lie. They are polar bears. They are polar bears. The Case Populaire of Kahnawake is also one of this year's generous organizations to donate to the activities of the parade. Their theme this year is an igloo. And they chose the Grand Marshals, Helen Montour and Trudy Thomas.
Oh, well, we have the manager here. Well, tell us a little bit about the float.
Okay, this is Happy Feet and the North Pole with the igloo, and we're polar bears and penguins. So happy holidays, everybody.
Great job. Look at that. There we go. Hello. That is just a beautiful float. Of course, we have Dega Lazar with us here, who's helping us out. Dega, you've seen a lot of things in your time. You've participated in a lot of things. Just give us some thoughts about what you're seeing so far.
Well, Joe, I'll be honest. I'm pulling double duty right now. This is my first parade that I've been to. You know, I lived in Toronto for a while, and now it's like to participate in community events like this. This is pretty cool, and I encourage anybody who, like me, who hasn't seen one before, come down here and do it. You know, make a note in your calendar for next year. So it's really cool. It's really cool.
Excellent. And of course, it takes a lot of volunteers to get this done. So. You see all of the people who are participating, the people who help build the floats, and even some of the marshals who are keeping the crowd safe by, you know, making sure they stay on the sidewalk. Of course, they make an exception for us because we get a chance to talk to some of the participants here. But it takes so much organization, and this year the Peacekeepers did it. And I know, we have our Master of Ceremonies and his assistant, along with some judges who are doing the judging here. We'll have some results for you a little bit later on. And of course, there's also gonna be some fireworks. So this year, a little bit special, first time ever doing it at night, but let's get a look here. Step by step, Family Center here. Look at this, here we go. And the best is that everybody in the parade is smiling and having a good time. Nobody looks like they're struggling. They're all enjoying it. And of course, when they smile, you, the people in the audience, smile. And when they smile, then there's more smiles on the way back. So this is such a joyous occasion. And it's something we always could use more of. Smiles and laughter here in Kahnawake and everywhere.
Food, which will be served,
and here are the gang from Playground.
Along with a little gift for the children going to visit Santa following the parade. And Santa will be at the Peacekeeper Station granting all your Christmas wishes and hopefully not signing any promise to appear. And now, the next float comes to us courtesy of Creekside Convenience. This is a business entry float. Their theme is a candy store decorated with lights. A fitting portrayal of a candy store by the candy store. You can see all those happy children waving, all hopped up on sugar. I'm gonna be up till midnight, running up and down the walls. But they're happy. Guys. That's the main thing. That's right.
What do you say?
Right you are.
Merry Christmas!
Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in the one horse.
Our next entry, number 15, the Kahnawà Memorial Hospital Center. This is a community organization entry, and they are featuring the Kahnawà Memorial Hospital bus. Where is the bus? It's parked right alongside the road. It's a stationary float. It doesn't move. All the patients are in the Kahnawà bus. The theme of the Kahnawà Memorial Hospital Center is that of a nightmare before Christmas. A perennial favorite. come holiday season.
And all the characters are there.
All the characters are there. We have Jack Skellington and the Oogie Boogie Man. And the other one. Up next, we have the ATVs and marchers of the Kahnawake Peacekeepers. Amongst the marchers, these are the newest members of the Kahnawake Peacekeepers. These are the rookies who were voluntold that they have to march in the cold, cold weather in their dress uniforms. And finally, our last float,
we got Santa,
brought to us by the Kahnawake Peacekeepers, the host.
So far, so good, Joe.
What do you got? What do you got to say to the people?
Merry Christmas, happy holidays.
And also one of the newest peacekeepers here joining us in this parade. How's the march been so far?
Cold, but we're surviving. Yeah. Merry Christmas, happy holidays.
And happy.
Hey, good stuff, guys.
On the fifth day of they are lovely.
And here we go, the big
thank
finish.
Did we win? Yawa, yawa go.
Wave to Santa,
wave
everybody.
To Santa. Wave to Santa.
Santa!
On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave.
Look at that float.
Rain breaks too hard.
Careful now.
Four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
In here, there we go. Merry Christmas. What do you guys have to say?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Hey, Santa Claus, how you doing? Well, well, well. There it is. Woo! I gotta tell you, this was a great parade, and it all ends too quickly. All that effort, but you know what? We're here at the Knights of Columbus, but they're going all the way up the highway. And as I came in here, there were just hundreds of people lined up. There's certain spots that are just open, so you get a whole bunch of people in their cars waiting. And then as soon as they come out, they jump out of the cars with the kids and stuff. It's just a wonderful event. And once again, thanks to the Kahnawake Peacekeepers. We have some judging that's going to be happening, and hopefully we'll have some of the results for you later on. But I hope you've enjoyed this year's holiday parade. It's been a great one.